The Honourable Member for Concordia.
Mr. Speaker, today is the first day of Mental Health Week, and we know that mental health is the next frontier in health care, and our government has continued to invest in health care and the benefit of all Manitobans. Mental health of children in particular is such an important element in their success, giving them the best chances in school and beyond. Can the Minister of Children and Youth Opportunities please tell the House about an important mental health announcement that she made earlier today?
The Honourable Minister of Children, Youth Opportunities.
I absolutely can. I am pretty excited about it. And I, along with my colleague, the Honourable Minister of Healthy Living and Seniors, were at Hydro Place today for the Canadian Mental Health Association's event, Get Loud, which I think we can all agree was a good place for me to be, somewhere where we get loud. So hopefully we can see both sides of us working on that, because we're getting loud to help out awareness for mental illness in our province and in our country. The stigma attached to that is one of the things that main things that keep people from seeking help. So during this event, we were able to announce the government's further investment of $2 million into a continuum of supports that range from mental health promotion and prevention to interventions and treatment for children and youth. It's a multi-year strategy that will start this year by identifying and supporting critical services and workforce needs and launching a program that will equip home visitor staff to provide mental health supports to at-risk parents and families, and we're very proud of this beginning. Thank you so much.